This program is rated PG. It contains themes and scenes which may not be suitable for very young audiences. Parental guidance is advised.
Be advised that the views and opinions of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Alam ng marami ito, ngunit itong hinaharap ng mga teachers at mga paaralan natin ay sa darating na mga taon dahil dito sa K-12 will result in billions of pesos of losses in terms of income for the next few years of teachers, scholarships lost by families or children of teachers, and of course schools through the period of adjustment kung mangyari talaga ito. That is why I lament the fact that our mainstream media has not given it as much attention as they do this boxer, who is a failed champion. But that's another matter. Yun lang, I had to say that because ito ang mga issues na kailangan natin bigyan ng oras, and that is why we on GNN were giving the time for representatives from the teacher sector and from the working people's organization, Federation of Free Workers, and the Suspend K-12 Coalition, this opportunity to give us an update and discuss with us yung their latest developments dito sa struggle ng mga teachers laban dito sa malaking fiasco na to. Na pinipilit ng pamahalaan na kailangan gawin despite the appeal of teachers who are on the firing line. Parang execution squad ito, for at least one. So we have Professor Rene Tadle, who has been with us twice, I think, before, to bring these issues to fore. And Ms. Rita Cusio, professor at the Sambeda College, university ng tawag ngayon, no?
College pa rin ba?
Okay. And representative of the Sambeda Employees Union,
College Union.
And of course, Sonny Matula, who has been with us here several times. We saw each other's rally doon sa Liwasang Bonifacio. And the first time I had a rally there was 1970. Hindi pa kayo pinapanganak. 1970. Ikaw medyo.
65 ako.
5 years old.
5 years old.
So, I'll start with the teachers, no? Rene, so, that was very impressive. Around 6,000 families ang tawag din yun, no? Because the children were there, the family, and the leaders were there. What did you hope to achieve there?
Well, we'd like to emphasize and to show government that actually the opposition to K-12, the call for the suspension of K-12, is a very, very important aspects. No? Ito yung talagang pinag-gustong ipaglaban ng mga tao na hindi lang sa isang... Kasi from ano yan, from left to right, right to left. So there are may mga labor unions, may mga teachers groups, may mga non-governmental organizations, and at the time, even before the rally, sabi ko pag we were able to get if we get the number around 1,000, masaya na kami. But for us to be able to reach that number,
6,000.
That you mentioned, parang it was really surprising for us.
Yeah, let me explain that I was also very impressed because Magdalo was there, Senator Trillanes, and I don't know if Ace Acedillo arrived, the two congressmen of Magdalo, but I knew many of the Magdalo people who helped in the organizing, no? Because I was in jail with them in the Manila Pen incident. 5 days lang naman ako. Sila 7 years.
Pero mas matagal lang tayo sa Marcelo.
Sa Marcelo, mas mahaba pa. But yun ang advantage of becoming aged na or senior na. Pinakakawala ka na sa 5 days. No? Anyway, so Then of course I was amazed that Magdalo and ACT Alliance of Concerned Teachers are together because ito talagang kaliwa ang ACT ano? And Magdalo is not rightist naman. I would say I put them at the center ano? And
there's another big group there of teachers and Teachers Dignity Coalition. So normally yan yung nag-aano TDC and ACT they're also there. So we are so happy that I think they put their differences together and unite in this particular advocacy.
And yun ang importante, I think that is one aspect that you wanted to show. This is a broad-based opposition, including FFW.
Isang nakita ko doon ang mas maganda ay yung trade union ay nagiging social movement. Hindi lang yung issue na nasa loob ng pagawaan, kundi kasali na rin yung social issues at yung issue ng itong legislative issue ito na pinaglalaban ng mga teachers, hindi lang mga teacher, ng kanilang pamilya, kasali na dito yung mga estudyante at mga parents natin. No? So isang broad at hindi lang trade union.
Ilang teachers union ang kasama ng FFW kung meron man?
Actually, nandun yung aming University of the East, Ramon Magsaysay.
Okay.
Nandun yung aming taga PSBA. At saka yung NCBA, yung kumanta na National Song, si Rodolfo, kumanta siya. Taga, tatlong union ng, dito sa Metro Manila.
And you have teachers unions
in other parts of the country.
In other parts of the country, all the way to Mindanao.
Central Philippine University in Iloilo, in Davao, we have Ateneo, Immaculate Conception, San Pedro Hospital, Holy Cross.
Did I see a streamer or a banner of Siliman University there in the rally? Parang
wala.
I saw something.
Wala. But they're part of
it.
Our
I saw it maybe in the manifesto that you
petition. Yes. Petition, I think.
They're
part of the petitioners.
Petitioner. Sa yung Angeles, hindi ba meron na
Holy Angels?
Holy Angels. Other parts of Mindanao, meron ba kayo na nag-represent dito sa petition and sa
Visayas?
Wala. Sa Visayas,
Siliman.
Siliman
and what other university?
In Metro Manila, we have Adamson, and then we have FEU, we have Mapua, and then we have UST. Yeah, I think there are 16 organized groups among the petitioners and four individuals.
So this should make Malacanang understand this is really broad-based. Mm-hmm. So how many do you think you represent in terms of warm bodies all over the country? How many teachers are there in the different organizations?
I mean, there are 86,000 teachers in the private school.
Kasama ba ang public din dyan sa petition? Sa start, or bawal sila dahil government nga sila?
Well, they also have their own they have their own
organizations.
Unions, but there is PS Link is
part of
the petitioners.
PS Link is a public sector union. The another one is Centro. There are a number of government employees in Centro EPL.
So you're representing hundreds of thousands.
Oh yes.
Naintindihan ba yan ng Malacañang at ng CHED? Naintindihan ba? Did the message carry across? What do you think?
Well, I don't know. Up to now, they remain insensitive. That's how we feel.
Okay. Insensitive until now.
It's like my column. I said nga, like BBL, ano, K to 12 is K9. K9 is tuta, aso. Like BBL. BBL is opposed by the nation, and yet ini-insist nang ini-insist. Ano? I wonder if you would agree to the parallel I made, because K to 12 is also falling in post, hindi ba? Can somebody give me a background? Because I've read that it involves IMF, World Bank, Rita, you have
Yes, we know that there is funding coming from the Asian Development Bank that supports the K-12. It's to the tune of 300 million pesos. And we know that when this multilateral lending institutions lend money or loan us money, there always is strings attached. Uh-huh. I think it's already a given. And so, we are very concerned about what those string attached will be and how it will impact the rest of the nation.
So they're really supporting this, yung mga foreign funders. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
There's also this Washington Accord and the Bologna Accord. In Washington Accord, that is yung sa engineering, dapat daw ang requirement of basic education is 12 years. Mm-hmm. Yung sa Bologna Accord naman, bago makapag-college yung mga estudyante, kailangan para ma-admit sila say, sa mga European universities, kailangan may 12 years of basic education din. So, and the Philippines is signatory to that. But what we are saying is, why are we going to follow all the time the dictates of other countries? At the same time also, even Singapore, yung ating Asian neighbor dito, hindi naman 12 years yung kanilang basic education.
Ilan sila?
Grade 10 up to grade 10 din. So hanggang 4th year high school din lang. Although they have pre-college. But what, in fact, what we are saying, that might be a better model.
That's right. That's
because
right.
If that will be the model, then there will be no displacement. At least in the short term.
Oh, that's a good point, yung Singapore. No? So let's push more discussion on this. Sunny?
Yung concern ng mga unions sa yung displacement of workers. Sa estimate nga umabot sa 75 to 80,000 nga yung ina-expect na mawala ng trabaho sa full implementation nitong K-12. So malaking kuan yan, malaking pabigat yan kung walang ka ng trabaho. At ang problema pa, walang hindi handa yung gobyerno. At ginagawa pa ata ngayon ang batas, bill pa lamang. At pinaproseso pa kung paano sasagutin yung mga nawawala ng trabaho ng mga manggagawa. So, hindi handa talaga kasi i-implement na next year tapos wala pang batas o wala pa yung fund na hindi pa na-appropriate para doon.
Walang batas.
Walang batas.
Na matugunan itong mga manggagawa na matatanggal.
Well, medyo na nag-blackout ako ng kaunti sa gigil sa ginagawa na naman nila eh, no? Dahil nga tanong ko nga ngayon habang dinidiscuss ito at insensitive nga ang Malacañang tulad ng BBL, kailangan ba may apat na teachers ang mapaslang muna ng I mean, do we need blood for them to respond to this ano? Oh, kasi magkano ba mawawala? I think it was computed before sa mga teachers and sa mga schools. Over a billion?
Hindi, ang sabi ng mga owners ng school, mga 150 billion yung mawawala.
150 billion? Ang iniisip ko lang, 1.5 billion.
No, 100. Ganun.
Assuming the schools exaggerated it, i-half mo pa, i-one-third mo pa, that's 20-30 billion pesos. At yung mga trabaho mawawala, na 80 mil, eh, taong may trabaho na. Samantalang ang ating ekonomiya nagpipilit na mag-produce pa ng trabaho para sa walang trabaho.
Kasi hindi sometimes they we quibble on the number, di ba? But you have to understand when you say 80,000 ang potentially mawawala ng trabaho or even less than that. But the point is, hindi lang naman yung mawawala ng trabaho, kung hindi yung pamilya din nung mawawala ng trabaho. Yung teachers, halimbawa, may limang anak, yung ganon.
Yung mga teachers kasi madalas yung package nyo kasama yung tuition ng mga bata, di ba? Ay, yung
mawawala.
Paano? Anong gagawin ng mga teachers? Do you really not only disrupt but practically destroy the lives of families? Sunny?
Yung kwan nga, yung dagdagan mo pa ng 2 taon. Yung nawalan ka na ng trabaho, tapos yung anak mo ay dadagdagan pa ng 2 taon. So masyadong mabigat, no? Masyadong mabigat sa kasalukuyan na ilan lang nga yun nag-graduate sa elementary? So, sa 15 million na elementary, sino makapasok sa high school is mga 6 million lang.
I'll give you a statistics, para simple. Sa 100 na nag-e-enroll sa elementary, 44 ang makaka-graduate sa high school. And out of that 44, only 27 will be able to finish college. Sa projection namin, and this was also mentioned, may mga studies na, minention dito dun sa petition ni Senator Trillanes, given 6.8 dropout rate, yung, kasi magdadagdag ka ng 2 taon, so people cannot, the students and parents cannot afford it. It means that yung 44 na makakagraduate sa high school, mababawasan yan, na ano na lang, na in effect para mga
14.
Pagkatapos yung makakagraduate sa college, 9 na lang. Ganon ka ano yung...
Okay. Yung statistics ni former Undersecretary Isagani Cruz na pre-present kaninang umaga lang sa National Conference of Employers ng Employers Confederation of the Philippines. Sa 15 million na mga high school, 6 million lang. Elementary, 15 million. Ang high school is 6 million. At 3 million ang college.
College.
So, More than kalahati lang po, 15 million, tapos 6 million lang, ilan yan?
One-fifth lang ang nagka-college.
Tapos magka-college, kalahati lang na high school.
One-fifth lang yung aabot sa college.
15 million, 6 million sa high school, and then 3 million sa college.
At saka ano yan, K-12 is anti-poor. Mm. Why did you say that? Right now, again, UNESCO data, ang nakakatapos lang ng college, nakakapasok lang sa high school is 87%. Mm. Dito sa mga extremely poor Filipinos. Pagkatapos sa mayayaman, yung mga mayaman na 94%. Mm-hmm. So, since magdadagdag ka pa ng dalawang taon, yung 87% na 'yon, bababa pa 'yon.
Bababa pa.
So, lalaki yung gap between the rich and the poor.
And in addition to what Professor Tadle said, no, we also found this document from NEDA comparing the salaries of people who graduated with a high school diploma as compared to those with college degrees and postgrad degrees. Mm-hmm. And the difference, if you're just a high school graduate, you get an average wage of 250 pesos. Mm-hmm. But if you're a college graduate, it's double that. Mm-hmm. So if we confine our students to simply just a high school diploma, mm-hmm. then we are actually producing, you know, a batch of cheap labor, mm-hmm. and at the same time, it's also a docile labor because mm-hmm. they are less likely to organize themselves, given the fact that they don't have, they probably will not acquire the critical thinking skills mm-hmm. needed for them to examine, no, their conditions and their experiences of exploitation.
On the other side, we hear that they say it will improve the employment opportunities mm-hmm. for these graduates. Mm-hmm. No, I don't believe it, but please express your views, the three of you.
Ito lang. We got these statistics from Ibon Facts and Figures. Mm-hmm. Last year, mga 1 million yung
OFW ba?
Hindi, basta 1 million na yung trabaho
na-generate. Okay.
Pero ang problema doon, dun sa 1 million na yon, that's for the informal sector. Mm-hmm. At saka, normally, mga part-time jobs. So, mm-hmm. There's also a study.
Informal sector from barbecue vendor to
cigarettes.
Cigarette vendor.
Yun.
So, even sari-sari store, yung nag-aalaga sa sari store, informal sector yan.
Oo, ganun. So, ang nangyayari dito, yung mga... So, may study rin, as early as 2010, na yung mga employers, hindi naman tinitignan kung ilan yung kanilang basic education o kanilang potential worker. Ang tinitingnan nila kung competent yung nag-a-apply, no? Na-graduate natin. So, yun ang tinitingnan, kung okay ba yung communication skills, may critical thinking ba. So, pero hindi sila na-absorb dahil wala, in the first place, there are no jobs. Mm. It's not a problem of whether they are
capable. What about the foreign employment, Sonny? Hindi ba yun ang sinasabi na dahil this is an international standard and system, mas madali sila ma-employ abroad?
Sa palagay ko, hindi yan ang origin na concern eh. Kasi maski wala pa yung K-12, 10% ng ating working population ay nasa labasan ng bansa at... maraming mga countries ang gustong-gusto yung mga manggagawang Pilipino maski hindi tayo hindi tayo sumusunod yung international standard nila, no? So palagay ko hindi yung ganun ka-urgent ang pangailangan. Dapat sana kung gagawa tayo ng mga pagbabagong ganyan, pinaghandaan muna yung impact nito sa ating dito sa Pilipinas. No, sa Pilipinas, na mawawalan ng trabaho. So, na hindi nagawa. Kasi palagay ko, hindi nagawa yan dahil ang mga manggagawa ay hindi nakonsulta rin.
Parang sa BBL, ginugoyo ang taong bayan. Sa BBL, there will be peace after signing. Oh. Pumalag yung MNLF at iba pa. Dito rin, ay dadami ang trabaho. Pero manggugoyo, that's the best word in Tagalog for it. No? They are deceitful just to pass this K-12 na gusto ng ADB.
I think they have not anticipated that the teachers and the other workers will react to the K-12. Kala nila masusubo, tatanggapin ka agad. Pero in a way, nagising din kami. And that's why right now, our movement is getting strong.
Good, good.
And we are really organizing and with the help also of FFW and the other labor unions who are more experienced.
Who are the other labor unions?
Kasali dito yung isa sa... Actually, yung substantial na
blocking... SOPM, PM, Partido Manggagawa, no?
Oh. Yung Partido Manggagawa, yung Sentro, yung FFW, may part doon ng TUCP na yung PS link ay nandoon. Bahagi yan ng tinatawag na pinaka-broadest coalition ng labor sa Pilipinas, yung nagkaisa. So, at least substantial number of nagkaisa affiliates are supporting this suspend K-12.
Okay. We also had affiliates from San Lacas, like BMP.
That's right. I saw San Lacas banner also there. And then Magdalo. So, there are two other questions I have. Politically, si Senator Trillanes is championing the struggle, including Ace Acedillo in Congress and Gary Alejano na Magdalo party list. Now, what about the other political leaders? Anybody giving support to this suspend K-12?
Ang feeling namin kasi nahihirapan kasi para mag-turn around sila because most of them supported the K-12. Because you have to understand, if there is really a consistent senator who was against K-12, it was only Senator Sonny.
We discussed this a long time ago then with Sonny, me personally.
All the rest.
At saka yung sa House of Representatives, yung mga
Makabayan Coalition. So, can we generate more doon sa Senate? Sino pa bang pwede? Possibility.
Well, I think that's our plan. We'll also be talking to some of them. Because I think right now, while they may be agreeable to or acceptable yung concept ng K-12, but I think a lot of dissenters will also realize that government is not ready. So that if we really force the full implementation of K-12, then it will mean wastage of government, of government's money, or
but
even people's money.
But we might even have to save government from itself. Eh.
Right.
Alam mo naman ang operation ng gobyerno, hindi nag-iisip yan, basta sumusunod doon sa, o nag-uuto sa taas, no? And that guy does not really have much gray matter. Ano? So, my next question is also very serious, but it may elicit some snickers, no? When are we going to lie in sa harap ng CHED, sa harap ng Malacanang, and so on, I'll be the first to volunteer. Dahil total, masarap naman humiga. Kahit na ano. To dramatize, you have to shock these people. Eh. It doesn't, we don't need to 44 martyrs. Although baka masagas isa sa atin. Baka, are we going to do that?
Well, it's funny. Huh? That's a tough question. Why? Because we had this assessment meeting last Wednesday as to the rally. And in fact, that idea came up. I think maybe one of these days we just have to really show how serious we are to lie down on the street.
But hunger strike, the other thing, you know? Hindi naman yung hanggang kamatayan na hunger strike, but at least symbolic hunger strike. Wala bang pare na pwedeng sumama galing sa Sambeda?
Well, we actually got the support of Bishop Pabilio, the Auxiliary Bishop of Manila. He actually issued a statement in support of the faculty who will, and non-teaching personnel who will be displaced.
Okay. Yeah. So some go ahead. Rene, go ahead.
He's active in the
social justice issues, you know. He's been with the Sumilaw farmers.
Yeah. But we have to get more bishops. What about
Si Bishop Pabilio ay very active naman niya. Meron kaming yung church labor conference na kung saan ay nandun siya at yung mga labor unions. Nandoon. At recently nga mayroong yung Church Labor Conference ay nakipag-engage sa Department of Labor, particularly on the issue of compliance of labor laws. Lalong-lalo na yung health and safety. Halimbawa, kahapon ba yun? The other day yung nasunog doon sa Valenzuela na may more than 70 workers ang naumatay. Kung maganda sana yung labor compliance natin sa health and safety, palagay ko ay hindi nangyari yon. Pero nangyari na, dapat yung ating Department of Labor at yung ating local government units ay titingnan yun at imbestigahan.
Take the 30 seconds. We're now at the end of our segment. Rene and then Sonny, go ahead.
Kinatawagan po namin yung aming mga kababayan at suportahan at tutukan ang isyong ito. Ipakita po natin sa ating gobyerno na tutol po tayo sa K-12 kasi ito makakasira lang sa ating edukasyon at masasayang lamang ang ating mga taxes kasi hindi pa handa ang gobyerno.
Okay, Sonny?
So, ang kinakailangan palagay ko rito ay ang pagkakaisa ng mga mamamayan, ng ating mga magulang, yung ating mga estudyante at yung ating mga guro. At ang pagkakaisa niyan, kung malalim at marami, palagay ko ay magtatagumpay tayo.
Sige. Ako ang unang tawagan niyo. Paghanda na kayong humiga at lumusob sa Malacanang at sa CHED. Maraming salamat po. The second segment will be about the updates on the COMELEC watch that we are engaged in. Binabantayan natin ang COMELEC. May bagong commissioners daw, pero bago mukhang walang magbabago sa sistema. Okay, let's take this break.
Thank you.
Okay.